Hello everyone. In this class, I shall discuss the operation and the frequency response characteristics of RC coupled amplifier. So RC coupled amplifier is basically the BJT amplifier, and it may be a single stage, it may be multiple stage. That means if you need high amount of gain, so you can connect multiple stage one by one. So that type of connection is basically called cascade connection, where output of first amplifier connected to the input of second, and the stages are connected by using some capacitor that is called coupling capacitor, this one. So the coupling is done with the help of capacitor. So this is, and the name indicates that it's RC coupled. That means the coupling is done basically using the capacitor. Okay. So this is the typical circuit diagram of RC coupled amplifier, and here total two stages are used. That means this is the stage one where transistor Q1 is used, and this one is the stage two where transistor Q2 is used. Now you can check that circuit diagram of each stage. Okay, so this is the stage one. Now see the transistor Q1, the amplifier is in the self bias or emitter bias or the voltage divider bias configuration. The resistance R1, R2, and RE, okay, that forms the self bias. The RC is the load resistance, you can say. And CB is the blocking capacitor. The capacitor CB blocks the unwanted DC component, which is coming from the signal. Okay, because if additional DC component is present and it is coming from the signal, so it may shift the Q point. That means suppose here you have already fixed the Q point by putting, by setting some voltage and current, by selecting a proper value of R1 and R2. But after that, if some additional DC component is coming, so that DC component, the DC value will be superimposed. Okay. And it may shift the Q point, and you will not get the proper amplification. So that's why we need to block the DC component which is coming from the signal side. So that's why this blocking capacitor is used. So it will pass the AC component and block the DC component coming from the signal source. The role of coupling capacitor is same. From the output of first stage, it passes the AC component to the second stage. So basically the coupling indicates, the name indicates it coupled to stage. Okay. So you can say this is also one type of blocking capacitor, because we are passing the output to the next stage, and also at the same time we are blocking the DC component. See, some DC component may be present here. Of course, the same DC component will be there because this resistance RC connected to the VCC. So some DC component will be present at this point. Okay. So we need to pass AC component only. So that's why the coupling capacitor is used. Another one capacitor, that is CE, is called the emitter bypass capacitor. Okay. So we can summarize here. So the CB and CC, that is basically the blocking purpose, and coupling capacitor. Coupling capacitor, okay. And so it blocks the DC part to prevent shifting of Q point. And the CE, that is called bypass capacitor, or sometimes it is termed as emitter bypass capacitor. This is used to improve gain at high frequency. Is to improve gain at high frequency. So how it can improve the gain at high frequency? So let us see. See, the, due to the presence of this RE, that is the emitter resistance, you know that it provides the negative feedback. And due to the application of negative feedback, the stability factor increases. That's why the self bias or emitter bias circuit provides a good stability compared to other type of biasing scheme. But at the same time, when the negative feedback is applied, one drawback of negative feedback is the gain is reduced. Okay. The overall gain of the amplifier reduces due to application of negative feedback. And At a higher frequency, at moderate or high frequency, the internal parasitic capacitance of the BJT, that is the diffusion capacitance and depletion capacitance, and that interconnect capacitance, and those are present due to the circuit connections. So those parasitic capacitance cannot be neglected at moderate or high frequency range. Okay. So due to the presence of those parasitic and internal device capacitance, what will happen? The gain of the amplifier will fall. Okay. So there are two reasons. The first one is that due to the presence of RE, although it provides a stability, but gain decreases due to the negative feedback. Second, at the moderate and high frequency, due to the presence of those internal device capacitance and parasitic capacitance, gain will try to fall. Now, if we can bypass the AC signal through some low impedance path, so that it will not affect the gain. Now see, this RE will provide a high impedance path for the DC signal and whatever that stability related to Q point, because the Q point is related to DC operation, okay, the stability remain unchanged, okay, because we are not changing the value of RE emitter resistance. But for AC operations, so you can check, the AC signal will be bypassed through some low impedance path, that is through CE, through this path. Okay, so it is not facing the resistance RE. So in this way, we can improve the gain, okay, which is lost due to the negative feedback, as well as due to the internal device and parasitic capacitance at moderate and high frequency. So the role of CE is very prominent in moderate frequency range as well as high frequency range. In low frequency range, the role of CE is not too much visible, but mainly for moderate and high frequency range, okay, CE plays a very important part in the frequency response of the RC coupled amplifier. Okay. So this is all about the circuit description. Now coming to the frequency response characteristics. The frequency response means here at the input side, let we are applying one signal. Okay, let it is a sinusoidal signal with fixed amplitude. We are not going to vary the amplitude. Let the amplitude is 10 millivolt or whatever, but we are going to vary the frequency. Okay, so we are changing the frequency starting from a very low frequency up to high frequency. And we want to observe what is the gain of this total circuit. Okay, so that is basically the frequency response characteristics. So frequency response characteristics means it is a plot of frequency versus gain. So generally, the frequency is plotted in a log scale because the range of frequency is quite large. So we cannot use linear scale for this plot. So the frequency, the x-axis, that is plotted in log scale. Okay. So let us see how the graph looks like. Okay. So here x-axis, it is the frequency, and y-axis, that is the gain, that is V0 by VI, okay, in dB. Okay. That is 20 log V0 by VI. Okay, that is called decibel. Okay. So the graph we will get like this. And the maximum, this is the maximum, okay, and we can draw one line. So that is exactly the 3 dB down to this point. So this difference is basically 3 dB. And you will get two intersections. This is one point. This is another one frequency point. So this one is called FL, this one is called FH, okay, this point and this point. So we have two corner frequency or two cutoff frequency, that is FL and FH. So FL is called the lower 3 dB frequency. And similarly, FH is called higher 3 dB frequency. Those are the definition of FL and FH. Now, depending upon the shape, we can divide the graph into three different regions. So this region up to FL, so this region we can say, this is called low frequency region. The region, this one, this is called mid-band or mid-frequency region. So between this FH and FL approximately, and after FH, this is high frequency region or high frequency response. Or high frequency response. So you can also mention low frequency region or low frequency response. This one is mid frequency response and this one is high frequency response. So we can divide the entire frequency response graph into three different parts. Now let us analyze each region separately. In the low frequency response, just see with an infringing frequency, the graph increases like this. The reason is, see the circuit, when the frequency value increases, what will happen? The reactance of the blocking and coupling capacitor, because the reactance of capacitor XC, that is equal to 1 by J2 pi FC. With an increasing frequency F, the value of the reactance X reduces, and the current flow through this capacitor, blocking and coupling capacitor, will increase. As a result, gain also increases, okay, with frequency, and it is visible here. See, the gain also increases with frequency. But at the mid frequency, see, the gain is almost constant. The gain saturates and the gain became almost constant. Okay. The reason is, at mid frequency region, the several things happen. The first one is, when you are increasing frequency, the reactance of blocking and coupling capacitor will continuously fall, and due to that, gain will try to increase, okay, as per our previous observation in low frequency region. But at the same time, the internal parasitic capacitance, the device capacitance, that is depletion capacitance, diffusion capacitance, etc., and the capacitance present in the circuit due to the wire connection and all those things, that is called parasitic capacitance, those capacitance starts acting and they are trying to reduce the gain. Okay. So if you draw the equivalent circuit of this amplifier, actually those capacitance are connected in the parallel, in the shunt. Okay, and due to their presence, the gain will fall. So one effect try to increase the gain, this one, okay. And here, due to the presence of the parasitic capacitance, gain will try to fall. So one effect is canceled by another one. So as an overall effect, the gain in the mid-frequency region almost constant. Now in the high-frequency region, that means at the last part, okay, so this part we are talking about, high-frequency region. So here, the current flowing through the blocking and coupling capacitor that reaches its maximum value. So we can say that the blocking and coupling capacitors are behaves like short circuit at high frequency. Okay? Because the value of the blocking and coupling capacitor is quite large. So this XC value, okay, almost negligible here, and whatever the current flows through blocking and coupling capacitor, that is almost, okay, reaches to its maximum value. Now, the frequency response characteristics in a high frequency region, that is entirely depends upon the response of the parasitic and internal device capacitors. And due to the presence of those, okay, the gain will fall. Okay. That means the contribution of blocking and coupling capacitor now saturates. Okay. They are not helping to increase the gain because their reactance came to the minimum value. But at the same time, the reactance of those parasitic capacitance and all those things, okay, it will fall. And due to this, the gain will try to fall. If you draw the equivalent circuit, those parasitic capacitance, they are present something like this. And when, okay, this capacitor part became shorted, so the input side voltage, okay, so if Vi is the input side voltage, equivalent voltage applied to the amplifier, so this capacitor behaves like short. So this voltage will be less. So output V naught will be just like A into Vi. Okay, so the gain will fall. So this is the just one equivalent explanation I can tell, okay. So just remember that when the parasitic capacitances are active and they are contributing, so the gain will always fall, not only in BJT, in any amplifying device. This is the same for FET devices also. And this is the reason why the gain will fall here. Okay. And the region, that is the frequency between this FL and FH, okay, so that is called the bandwidth. So this is the bandwidth. So we can say bandwidth equal to FH minus of FL. Sometimes it is denoted as 3 dB bandwidth. Okay, 3 dB bandwidth. Okay. So FH and FL, those are two cutoff frequency or corner frequency termed as 3 dB frequency. Okay. So this is all about the frequency response graph of RC coupled amplifier. Now coming to the application area, advantage and drawbacks. Okay. So RC coupled amplifier provides a very good frequency response, especially for entire audio frequency range. Okay. That means for entire audio range, the frequency response characteristics you are getting That is, you will get almost flat response over entire audio range. And if you need more number of, it's more amount of gain, so you can cascade, you can connect more number of stages. Suppose here I am using two stage, okay? So if the gain is not sufficient for any application, then you can add another one stage, okay? Of course, the bandwidth will fall. So that part we will discuss in some other class, why the bandwidth will fall and when we are adding more number of stages. Anyways, the gain will increase. The advantage you will get, the gain will increase. Okay. So this is another one advantage you can highlight. The drawback is the poor impedance matching. Okay. You know the maximum power will be transferred when the source impedance will be complex conjugate of load impedance, H per maximum power transfer theory. But in RC coupled amplifiers, there is no facility of impedance matching. So the impedance matching is not good. And another one thing, we have checked that in especially for low frequency region, the blocking and coupling capacitor, their reactance is very high. Because when the AF is smaller, the value of X will be higher. So that's why the gain is less in low frequency region. Started from a very low frequency, see the gain is very small here. So we can say that very low frequency components are less than 50 hertz or less than 100 hertz here. Okay, they cannot be amplified properly due to the higher reactance of blocking and coupling capacity. So those are some drawbacks. And the application is, it is widely used in audio amplifier and television, radio, etc. But nowadays, listen, that all the audio amplifiers are being replaced by the integrated circuits. Okay. And also in earlier days in the public addressing system, the RC coupled amplifier was used. Okay. So those are the application domain of RC coupled amplifier. So thank you all. Today up to this.